good morning to one and all. I'd like to welcome you to New Testament Fellowship on this wonderful day, Resurrection Day, that we celebrate together. Here to celebrate Jesus' resurrection from the dead. He gave us life, those who believe in Him. So again, we welcome you for your first-time visitors. We spend a good deal of time in praise and worship. We're going to do things a little bit differently today. We're going to start with a little bit of worship, maybe 15 minutes or so, just to get our hearts in the right place. And then we've got a program today. And then the main body of worship will take place after the program. So why don't we stand? Again, for your visitors, feel free to worship along with us. Ask that your hearts will be open. Let God minister to you just where you're at. He knows your needs better than you know yourself. Father, we thank you. We give you praise, God. We adore you. We exalt you. We magnify your name, oh God, for who you are and what you've done for us. Lord, we gather today to bless you, Lord, to thank you, God, for what you have done, that you willingly gave your life for us, God. So, Father, we're here to celebrate your victory over death, the victory that you've given each one of us. So, Father, we give this time of worship, this whole program, Lord, to you. We give it to you, God, that you would have your way with every one of us. So we thank you, God. We bless you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Glory to the Lamb of God. Glory. We rejoice and Jesus, we celebrate your victory. Jesus, we revel in your love back in. Jesus, we rejoice to set the free. Jesus, your death has brought us. Jesus, your death has brought us. Jesus, your death has brought us alive.
And Father, we thank you for your goodness, your grace, and mercy to us. Be with us the rest of this time together and always. We thank you. Ask in the name of Jesus. You can be seated.
Wonderful. I'd like to really extend a very warm welcome to you this morning on a very special Easter Sunday. We really are blessed with a lot of things that are going to be happening this morning. I'm looking forward to seeing some of the different things. The lot has fallen to me to have the infamous clipboard for announcements, since the other pastors are going to be involved in dressing up in other manners. You'll see in a little bit. But we're here to celebrate this morning the pinnacle, the most dramatic event that history has ever seen up to this point. The death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And it's the main reason that we are here. In fact, without Jesus being risen from the dead, without the resurrection, we were just singing to the ceiling. But because of the fact that he is living, he is alive, he's risen from the dead, the songs that we sing take on a much more personal manner. So if you're new this morning, we want to welcome you. Perhaps it's even a new type of experience for you to see people at church, you know, singing and clapping and hopping around or doing whatever we were doing. And the main reason is because Jesus Christ is alive today. And we're celebrating the fact that because he's alive and because of the fact that he died on the cross and rose in victory over death, our sins can be forgiven. And our sins this morning are in a sense retroactively placed upon the cross to the point where we don't have to be punished for the things that we've done wrong. We don't have to be punished for the sins that we've committed because Jesus himself voluntarily, because he loves us, took that punishment upon himself. But he didn't stay in the grave. But he rose again from the dead, and we're celebrating that this morning. So that's good news. If I've ever heard good news, that's good news. So, do we have any visitors this morning? Anyone here for the first time? We'd like to welcome you. But if you wouldn't mind, if you would like, we have some things to give out to you. Little brochures for each of your households. If you'd like one of those, would you keep your hand raised for a little bit? Huh? And this nice-looking young guy is going to give you something to read. Very good. What we'd like to do is go through a few announcements, and I'll be back there in a little bit to give you those cards. Because of the dynamic of the way the room is set up this morning, and because of the fact they're going to be using the back room for changing and different things, we're not going to be having the 3 to 5 year old in Sunday school. So if you would, try to keep your children with you. If your child starts to run amok, they start to sing in an operatic voice, we'd encourage you, if you can, to take them further in the back room. And we realize that the potential here when you get a lot of kids together is for them to try out some new notes. So we'd encourage you, if you can, as best you can, to go on back until you feel like you've got things under control, then feel free to come back into the service. Okay. We'd also like you to do, if you are a first-time visitor, we'd like you to, there's a little card that you were given as well. If you wouldn't mind, would you fill that out? And there's a little offering box over, actually, in the side, a little person that's in the back. But we've changed things around a little bit, and we're facing this way. So the offering box is right over there. Would you join me in a word of prayer? We'd like to ask God to come and visit us this morning in a special way. There's been a lot of work that's gone into this presentation, countless hours, and it's really been done as an expression of joy and of love, and folks are really looking forward to worshiping God through the things that we're going to be seeing and experiencing. And what we really want more than anything else is for God's presence to be here in a way that you this morning would have an experience with the living God. So would you pray with me? Let's ask the Lord to come and to meet with us in a special way. Father, with confidence because of what Christ has done upon the cross, we come into your presence. We ask, Lord, that you would have your way with our time today. Lord, we pray, Lord, I pray for each one of us. Lord, I pray that from the youngest to the oldest, that you would touch us this morning, Lord. That each one of us would have a sense of meeting with you. Why don't we just go through the walk through the week now? See, I'm not used to doing this, so I'm forgetting things, okay? So if you look, you'll see that Monday we have canceled the youth and young adults meeting, okay? Tuesday we have the Promise Keepers at 8 o'clock in Carlisle. Can we move that up a little bit? I'm going to have to look and see this myself, because I'm in a very difficult angle for this. We should practice at 7 o'clock. Nothing on Thursday. I'm getting this
food truck.
And the food truck is on Friday.
Foundation class.
And the foundation class is Friday night. Isn't this professionally done? The good news is what you're going to see in a few minutes is much better prepared, okay? Amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank you.
gave my brother and I a new name. Sons of Thunder, he called us, after the time we wanted to call down fire onto the heads of those who wouldn't believe our message. What foolish little children we can be. Quick to judge, quick to point the finger, huh? But when I think of the patience and the love that Jesus had for me and for all of us, I'm overwhelmed. I'll never forget the last night that we spent with Jesus. All of us were there, Peter, Andrew, Philip, Nathaniel, Judas, all of us, celebrating the Passover together, as we always did. But something was strangely different about this night. Jesus stood up from the table, and he took off his robe, and he tied a towel around his waist. None of us knew what he was up to until he took a basin of water, and kneeling down, he began to wash our feet. Jesus, you're our Lord and our Master, not our servant. I felt so overwhelmed and overcome by love for him that night. All I could do was when he came back to the table and sat down, I found myself leaning over to him and laid my head into his chest. A new commandment I give you, he said, that you love one another, even as I have loved you. And then he asked us to lay our lives down for one another, even as he was about to do for us. Well, listen, a few of us are about to celebrate the Lord's Supper together. Would you join us? I'm sure the Lord would want you to. And so as we go to prepare the bread and the juice, would you prepare your heart to receive and to remember what the Lord has done for all of us?
Thank you. and he broke it, saying, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Take it and eat. Do this in remembrance of me." You take the bread. Just as he did with the bread, he took the cup and he blessed it, saying, "This is the blood of the new covenant, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Drink it and do this in remembrance of me." Father, we thank you for your Son, Jesus, who became our servant and willingly went to the cross for us. And Lord, we look forward to one day sitting down at the table with you again. Until that time, we will do this to remember what you have done for us. And we thank you and praise you, our God. In Jesus' name.
Thank you. Nailed to the cross. saying with so much malice, so much contempt, that he be betrayed, He was denied, a trial, denied by those who followed him. Yet even so, in this darkest hour, there's no hate in this man. God was there. I heard him. I heard him plead forgiveness. I heard him plead mercy on us. Forgiveness for those who murdered him. It's a face I'll never forget. As long as my feet touch this earth, until I breathe my last breath, this face is before me. For truly, this man is the Son of God.
Thank you.
mind among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus, who though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Therefore God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and then under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
Oh, Yeah, we're Sunday.